Now, where does the tax money goes? There's a royalty to the king, to the government. I work hard for it, my income, why should I pay? Can you argue to the king? But when it comes to God who provides you this thing, you're arguing with him. Why should I give you? Why do we give? See, I don't want a Christian, I don't want to see a believer in our church, in our those who are following us, to be blind in giving. When a pastor come and say, give tithes, okay, give. It's not like that. You must know why you are giving. They ask God, in what we have robbed you? He said, in tithes and offering. Now, if you go to the temple those days, there will be a box there, an offering box. If you put your hand inside and take that money, then God can say that you robbed him. True or not? But why did God say that the tithes, when you don't put in tithes, it's called as robbing? If you put your hands into that box, you take out, then it is called robbing. Okay? That's the fact. But the tithes money is with you. You don't want to give, but God claims that as robbing. Why? Because in the beginning, he said that the tithe belongs to him. Before you get a job, before you get your pay, 10% of it is already belong to Jesus, to God. Hallelujah. Your work is to do good, pass it to God. The thing is, you change your mind, say, no, I'll keep it for myself. Like Ananias and Sapphira, I'll keep it for myself. Hallelujah. And that's why God said that you are robbing me. God is accusing you. He's putting a charge on you. He's not simply giving a false accusation. That's the truth. When you don't pay your tithe, you are robbing. Hallelujah. Now this is the problem with people. You know, when it is small, they can give. When it is big, they can't give. I remember a man of God, once he shared a testimony. A man went to a pastor and said that, Pastor, I'm struggling. What is struggling? When I was earning 500 ringgit, I was able to pay 50 ringgit of my tithes happily. When I was earning 5,000 ringgit, I was able to pay 500 of my tithe. But now that I'm earning 50,000, I find it is too hard to pay the 5,000 to God. And therefore the man of God said, now man, I will help you. I will help for you now. No problem. I'll pray to God that God will give you back that 500 again so you can give 50 happily. And then he said, no, man. I still have that 45,000 is enough. God has given you 45,000, but you are not able to give up 5,000 to God. Hallelujah. Greediness. Why did God say it belongs to him? What is the purpose? It is he who gives you the power. It is he who gives you the strength to work for your living. If God did not give you the power to your feet, to your arms, you would not be able to work. God has given you the source, given you the strength to work and earn. Okay, he has given you the strength to work and earn. Why can't you pay the tithe to him? Without him, you wouldn't get that 45,000 or 4,500 or the 450 or the 4 ringgit 50 cent. See, I'm decreasing. But you can't pay that 50 cent to God. You can't pay that 50 ringgit to God or the 5 ringgit to God. You know, this is the problem with us today. Hallelujah. God is the source. He is the reason why you can go for your living. You can earn some money. Bible says, remember. How we can remember? This is the way of you remembering. See, you buy a house, you pay a tax for it. It's your money. You work, you pay tax for it. You buy a car, you have to pay the tax for the car. You have to pay the road tax as well. Now, where does the tax money goes? There's a royalty to the king, to the government. Today when we are going through a hard time, they use the money to pay back, isn't it? You know, this is how the money goes to pay the ministers. It's a royalty because they are doing their work. Hallelujah. Whether you like it or not, you have to pay. Can you go and argue to the king? I work hard for it. My income, why should I pay? Can you argue to the king? But when it comes to God who provides you this thing, you are arguing with him. Why should I give you? In the book of Mark 12:17, Jesus said, give to Caesar what belongs. The Caesar is the king. They have to pay the tax. He said that, give to him what belongs. Because the coin that you are using has the king's face on it. Hallelujah. It means it belongs. You are doing your work, everything based on that coin, on that money. It has the king's face. It means it belongs to him. The kingdom belongs to him. You have to pay him and to God what belongs to him. And still people are saying that, oh, in the New Testament, God did not speak about tithes. Isn't this very clear to you? That in the book of Mark 12:17, he said that you have to pay the tax to the Caesar and you have to pay your tithes to God. There's not much difference with the tax and tithes. Hallelujah. It's almost the same method. Hallelujah. You call God as your king and that's your tax. That's your tax. Hallelujah. When we rob God by not giving tithes, we are looking for curse. What kind of curse? Whatever we do, it will not prosper. Whatever we do, whatever you try, you apply, become failure. Hallelujah. Even though you earn millions, it will be insufficient for you. It all will go out paying the debts. Even you become a billionaire also, it all will go off paying the debts. You will not have that peace, you will not have the joy. That is the curse. Hallelujah. This is why many are living, struggling, insufficient poverty. Hallelujah. We don't have the heart to give. When you know who is the source of your income, you are not shaken. Hallelujah. That's why tithes is very important. Hallelujah. When we are not blessed, we are not, you know, prospering, it's because it's a curse. We don't pay tithe to God. You feel like, God, understand me, I'm earning only 5 ringgit. Why should I give the 50 cent to God? God is seeing your truthfulness, your faithfulness in that 50 cent. When you don't pay that, you are robbing them. Because it belongs to God. The word says, it belongs to the Lord. It is holy. Can you take what is holy from the Lord? You are not supposed to touch what belongs to God. That is tithe. Hallelujah. Now, how to give tithes? Tithes and offering is not the same. Okay? Tithe is your commitment with God. Tithe is your commitment. You have to pay your utilities, your rental, your water bill, your electric bill, like that. Tithe is a commitment for you. Hallelujah. It's a commitment, just as how you have to pay your utilities. The house utilities are all a commitment, so it is also a commitment for you. But offering is your choice. Offering is your own choice. You want to give, you can give. You want to give. Now, again, I'm telling you, tithe is your commitment not to a church, to a God. Clearly written that, bring the tithes into the house of the Lord. Hallelujah. Not to some other places. Some people, oh, I know this servant of God. That's what I know. Bring it to the place, the church where God is talking to you. There are many times people, they say that, Pastor, why not I give my tithe to the poor? Why not I give the tithe to the poor? Again, I'm telling you, they are in great confusion. Tithes and giving the poor, two different stories. Two different things. Hallelujah. You see, in the book of Malachi chapter 3 verse 10, it says that, bring your tithe into my house. My house, God's house means the ministry, the church. Tithe supposed to go to the church, not to the poor people. Hallelujah. And if you don't give the tithe to him, it mentions that you are robbing God. You are robbing God. But in the book of Proverbs just now, we read that when you give to the poor, you are lending to God. They're two different things. When you don't give the tithe, you are robbing God. When you give the poor, you are lending to God. So how can you bring the tithe and give to the poor? Why should God borrow from you your own the tithes that belong to him? If tithes are to be given to the poor, why should God borrow from you? Hallelujah. Or are you trying to make a new way for God? Hallelujah. Giving is for you to live a blessed life on this earth. Hallelujah. It is between you and God. Hallelujah. So some of you would think that tithe means it's the last part of your income, the balance. No, it's the first 10% of your income. No, when you got your pay, the first 10% must put it away and then pray, Lord, this is your blessing toward me. You are the provider, you are the source of everything. In remembering you, I give this tithe. Hallelujah. And then you should pay the tithe. It's not that just a gift like that. No. Hallelujah. Secondly, tithe is a way of you demonstrating your faith in God. When you give tithe, especially when you are very in a very tight situation, you know, insufficient, you begin to give, you are demonstrating that you trust in God even in your insufficient. Hallelujah. You believe that God will provide. Hallelujah. So it doesn't matter. Some people say that I'm very tight. I'm telling you, even if you are tight, when you begin to pay your tithes to God, your burdens will be loosened. God will make a way. You want to see God help you supernaturally, then you have to start sowing your tithe in faith. Hallelujah. It works like this. This is how it works. You have to pay your tithe. You need to sow in order to reap. There's nowhere we can see that there's a tree is bearing fruit first. We have to sow it, then it will come out. Our work is that. That's what God is expecting even in your financial as well. Hallelujah. So this is what you should understand. If every month if you give your tithe faithfully, God will faithfully run your house without any problem. There will be no hindrance at all. You will have more every month even after paying up everything. Hallelujah.